Kevin Stefanski talked about what he saw against Lamar Jackson, against Steelers yesterday, as well as against the Browns last week.
He's a great player, Mary Kay. You're never going to shut him out. I mean, he makes plays. That last drive, they did a nice job of getting in position to score, scored, and you know, obviously it was a great play with that two-point conversion on both sides. So, but with Lamar Jackson, as you know, he's going to make plays, and it's our job to limit them. And I think there's some really good things that we can work off of from our last ball game.
And did you also see opportunities there? There again, he was sacked 7 times. So did you see some things on film where you can't get to him?
Yeah, I thought Pittsburgh did a nice job. They varied their package up in terms of pressure and coverage, and ultimately they got him on the ground. Now, he's hard to get on the ground. The first guy oftentimes does not succeed, so you really have to be relentless to the football when you're playing Lamar.
The one thing that you did see quite a bit, Kevin, and some turnovers again, so that'll be key for the Browns' defense.
That's been the key since kind of, you know, the early part of this season when they were on that bit of a roller coaster of consistency, as this team has been this entire season, the consistently inconsistent team that we have seen. One thing that I know the defense has put a lot of emphasis on, when they were getting some of that early pressure and some of those early sacks, they weren't getting a lot of turnovers. Now, they got those 4 interceptions. The offense couldn't capitalize on it. Lamar still kind of showing that he is prone to those interceptions. Right now, he's in that kind of state of play, but he can always escape and make those plays downfield. We saw it countless times with Clowney. You saw how frustrated he was. Myles Garrett, you know, shaking his hand because they, you know, just kind of tipping his cap, just being able to make that play to Mark Andrews in the end zone. And you saw it yesterday. Yeah, the Steelers were able to get a lot more sacks than the Browns were in their game, but there were still times where another defense of the year candidate, year after year, TJ Watt, he's going after him and he still can't get Lamar Jackson on the ground. So it's changing up those looks. It's finding a way to somehow contain him in the pocket to get that pressure home and get it home quick, because once he gets outside and you're having to chase after him as fast as you may be, he just is so electric and has that it factor once he gets out of the pocket where he can make those plays down the field, or he can, you know, kind of find that gap that's opened up at that point with the playground-like, backyard-like football that ends up being played in those cases to then run down the field, make a big play with his legs, if not score a touchdown. And when we saw that last time at First Energy Stadium on Monday Night Football in that epic game last year. So that is something the Browns are going to have to balance. Contain him inside the pocket, get him on the ground, not allow him to gain confidence by being so electric with his legs as we know he is. It's easier said than done, Dave, but that's got to be the key, and they got to find a way to maybe change up their looks from what they showed 2 weeks ago.